So if you could describe yourself in 2 to 3 words as a person, not as your character, what would that be?
I'm just going by what people have told me. I would definitely say sexy, quirky, intelligent. Those would be the 3 words.
What's the meanest thing that you've ever said to someone?
This goes back a ways, and I don't remember saying it, but I have a cousin who has issues with her weight, and evidently when I was a little girl, I called her fat. And she's still holding it against me 30 years later, more than 30 years. So I just don't want to age myself, but...
Does she still have an issue with her weight?
Well, she does. I mean, she's got that thing where they staple your stomach, and she's gotten a lot of lipo, but she's still a big girl. Yeah.
What do you think was the highlight of the first shoot date for you?
You know, I wouldn't say this, but it was actually fun to come in and do the confessional. I actually enjoyed that.
Cool. Do you think anyone mentioned you in his or her confessional?
No. They don't really know me. I mean, I'd be surprised.
Can you tell us a little bit about a person in your life that gives you the most stress?
My husband. I mean, I think most married people would say that. He's just a very unique individual, and even though we've been together now about 18 years, I find out that I know him less and less every day. And I'm really questioning the person who I married, because it's so completely different from who he is now. And I guess I'm kind of struggling with, do I want to continue staying married to him, because he's not the person that I met 18 years ago.
Is he... react surprised at your mention of that, or does he sort of know that he's changed?
I think he's in denial about a lot of things in his life, and the demise of our marriage would probably be one of them. We've obviously had discussions about it, and I would say back in the end of October, early November, we talked about it, and he's like, well, you know, if you want to get divorced, I'm not going to oppose it, and whatever you want, you can have. I'm not. And I said, well, yeah. I mean, basically, I could get whatever I wanted if that's what I wanted. But he has not brought up that discussion again.
Is that stressful?
Well, it's not stressful. It is and it isn't, because every day I feel a little more sad that I realize, like, that this has happened to our relationship. So I can clearly identify with the character struggles that my character Debbie's going with, because I think there's some kind of a veil that not just myself, but I think most people put on themselves to not look at the painfully obvious things that are going on in their life. And then there's one day where you come to the realization that you say, I just cannot deny this anymore. And that is really sad, because then you have to say to yourself, okay, well, now that I know this, what am I going to do about it?
I'm sorry, you said your name was Katie?
Terry.
Terry.
That's okay.
Can you tell us about your own religious beliefs?
Well, I was brought up Roman Catholic, as most people of Spanish descent are. And I want to say maybe 15 years ago, I started to really question it and started exploring what other spirituality there was out there. And I would now call myself more a Buddhist. I believe in reincarnation. I've actually seen some of my past lives. I think it's really sad how, in general, religions have used man's fear of the unknown to control them. I think that's kind of where I'm at, is realizing that religion was created to create a kind of order so that people wouldn't just do crazy things.
Do you want to tell us about your worst romantic relationship and why was it bad? If we haven't already touched on it.
Well, I think to some extent, you know, when you come into a relationship and you want to say yes, you know, I'll be committed to you, we'll have a marriage, I mean, you go on what your idea of marriage is, but other people may not see eye to eye on that. And I think that's one of the problems here in society, is that everyone has a different interpretation of what a marriage is. And nobody's, either people are changing the rules as they go along, or what I've seen a lot is that most men are not willing to get a divorce because they don't want to lose half of their shit or what they've accumulated, and they feel they're entitled to keep all of it. I wouldn't say that's like my worst romantic failing, but I think most women who have been married can, and if they've not been 100% satisfied in their marriage, are going to say society fed us a lot of baloney about what marriage should be, and in reality it's not really that. So I think that we're, as little girls, we're, oh, you're going to grow up and you're going to meet this Prince Charming and he's going to be wonderful and he's going to whisk you away and take you to his kingdom and they lived happily ever after. And then you get to a point where you say, wow, that was really a fairy tale. This does not exist. It may exist for some people, but for the vast majority of us, it does not. And I think most married women who've been in long-term relationships, as I, would have to agree. There's very few marriages that make it, you know, to the 25-year mark nowadays. I think most people choose to end it and move on. So I would say, from that standpoint, and that we're brought up to believe a certain thing, and then realizing the reality of it, that could be, that kind of was the biggest, I would say it's a disappointment. It's the biggest romantic disappointment of my life. Sure. Mm-hmm.
This is a fun one. What is your dream vacation?
Well, I actually have done my dream vacations already, but I've done so much traveling. I can't believe that I've been so fortunate. For example, for my honeymoon, I went to Fiji, to a very exclusive island that only people who are very wealthy or celebrities go to. You may have heard of it. It's called Turtle Island. It was amazing. I lived in Argentina for 2 months so that I could perfect my Argentine tango. I've been to Europe probably, I go to Europe about every other year. It has been averaging out since about 2000, so for just 2010, I was out of the country for a quarter of it, 2 months in Argentina, and then a little over a month in Spain, France, and then I came back to, I was in Amsterdam and Barcelona then for a week, or 10 days or something. So, I mean, that's pretty amazing. But if I could pick another dream vacation, I think I would do something different, like, okay. I think my dream vacation would be, this is what I would do if I had the funds. I would rent a Range Rover, and from China, I would drive through Mongolia, and maybe spend some time with, like, the nomadic people and live in a yurt and ride their crazy little tiny ponies. And then I would get back, do that maybe for a week, and then get back in the Range Rover and drive up into the mountains of Tibet and just kind of, I don't know, hang out in Tibet for like a couple weeks or something. And yeah, that would be really fun. I mean, if I had the funds, I would do that in a heartbeat.
What's your most embarrassing moment?
I don't know. I'm trying to think here. Embarrassing, like in what kind of way? General sort of way?
I guess it wouldn't have to be something you did. Yeah, I feel some of my most embarrassing moments have been embarrassed for someone else, too. Or the physical comedy of my life, if I'm like tripping over something. So
okay.
I guess if something stands out where a moment that you felt really embarrassed by.
Well, this is, I wouldn't say it's embarrassed in the general way that people would call it, but I think that a moment I would like to take back in my life, if I could relive part of my life over again. My mom had diabetes very bad, and it led to her demise. And when she was sick for a lot of the time, I could not see her sick, so I just kind of didn't go visit her. And then one time she was in the hospital, and it was for something I thought was pretty routine, but later on I just found out from my sister that she had actually had a diabetic coma. They had stabilized her and she was in the hospital, and then she then choked on some food in the hospital and then passed away. But meanwhile, she was in another coma, and I went to visit her, and I remember being in the room and she had one of those respirators on, and I felt so terrible because I felt I had failed her as a daughter, that I hadn't been for her when she needed me most. So I don't know, it's not embarrassing in the general sort of way, but if I could redo that part of my life, I would do it a lot differently.
If this was a reality competition series, who do you think you would ally with?
I would ally myself with the guy who's playing Scout because he seems kind of sneaky, kind of like his character. And maybe the guy playing my husband because he's kind of mean, so maybe he would have like, he would have a way of like one-upping other people. So those would be the two I would try to ally myself, just because they seem like they're not above the board. I don't know if their characters definitely are not above the board, or maybe they are. My husband is supposed to be like this holy righteous guy, but I think that's just a front for his failings as a human being. The character, I'm not saying the guy playing him, but actors are picked to play characters that best represent themselves, so I think those two would be the ones to ally myself with.
Okay. Who do you think is the best leader or performer out there?
I really like the young man, and I don't know his name, that played my son, Ro.
Mm-hmm.
He seems to have a really good handle on the character, and I also think the guy playing Scout has a pretty good handle on his character.
Do you think there's the worst person out there? Who do you think that would be?
Do I have to make this judgment call?
Okay. No, let's phrase it this way, because I think this is a lot easier. If you were a casting director, and right now, based off what you know out there, you had to
cut a person?
Cut someone, yeah.
I think his name's Juan.
Okay.
But I'm, you know, I just don't know if he's not a good, because we're not really supposed to look at the scripts ahead of time, so maybe he's just not like, you know, like a cold reader,
mm-hmm.
which is a skill that's pretty hard to develop. It's not hard to develop, but once you develop it, you just kind of go with it. But he's also playing a lot of characters, so I will say that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he can't really, he doesn't really have like a through line. He's just got like a bunch of little characters.
Okay.
But he's a nice guy.
Yeah. That's all I have for you. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Question.
Thank you.
Yeah.